Okay, I'm called Bina Jackson Lujang. I'm from Southern Sudan. I'm here doing my master's in gender and peace studies. The separation of the South is being done because the Southerners, they feel that they're second class in this country. And it was being done purposely because they want to become a first class citizen in their own homeland. But I think that this separation cannot bring anything very bad between us, because since before we are brothers and sisters, we are staying together, we are sharing common things and then common goals together. This is like two brothers. They have been each and everyone goes to his side and then settle, and then he built himself. For Southerners, they are still in need of Northerners. This, I believe in that, that South cannot be strong without a Northerners, even North cannot be strong without a Southerners. That is in my feeling. And then I'm confident that if all of us, the two, join their hands, and then they are not worried about this separation, I'm sure we'll build a Sudan as general. Northern and South Sudan will be strong later on. The issue of women in South Sudan is a very, very huge problem. Women in South, the majority of women in South, they are illiterate. So they need to be educated, and then they need to be reinforced, empowered. Because if we don't empower these women, and then they are the majority of the population in South, it means that Southern Sudan will not grow well. And the challenges of women in South, as we know that women are dependent. If you are illiterate, you are depending on one side. So they are facing economical problem. They are facing a lot of challenges. They are facing a problem to get work, jobs is one of their problems. And then now in Southern Sudan, most of the women, they are now doing this labor work. They are cleaning roads just for survival. And then also, as we know that women are subordinated since before, and then they are sharing this the same discrimination. Also, women in South, they are also a marginalized group. We need to eradicate this gap, because if we know that women are the marginalized group in the society, it means that this country will not grow if we don't educate this group. So education of women, as some people say, that if you educate a woman, you educate a nation. If we are able to educate these women, it means that we'll be able to educate the nation.
My name is Noon Sharif, and I have graduated from Medicine Ahfad, and right now I'm doing my master in gender and development. When I joined Ahfad University for Women, we have this course about women's studies, and it helped me actually to realize a lot of answers for many questions that I have been asking about the situation of women in Sudan, and about like certain situations that I personally been through. And I just became involved in this women's studies and women's rights also. So after graduation, I heard about this program, and I thought this is the right path for me because I want to work for women in Sudan. I choose gender study so as to be able to work with NGOs and help in developing the situation of women in Sudan. And Also, what I think is gender and health is very much related to each other. And I think by combining gender studies and my medical background, I'll be even more able to help women in my country.